In this lesson, we discuss how to apply the DSS in a real situation. We will speak about the steps to perform, what the most common challenges and situations are, and how to improve the quality of the technology selection process. The practitioner will have to use the DSS, the technology guidelines, the material available on the website, and what was introduced in the previous lessons. The DSS application process requires a set of steps. Data will have to be collected from the field in order to provide inputs to the DSS. In case of other pieces of information, simple clarifications are needed, a further data collection has to be arranged. This iterative process comprises both the assessment phase and the use of the DSS and can be considered concluded when the picture is clear and all the DSS questions replied. The output is a ranking of the most appropriate technologies, but other aspects have to be considered into more detail. Only after a market analysis and a final selection involving different stakeholders, the humanitarian action can be designed. First of all, the process has to be planned, starting from the assessment phase. It has to consider local conditions and different data collection techniques should be applied in order to triangulate the findings and check their reliability. Generally speaking, direct observation should always be included. The assessment will include one or more aspects of food utilization and will primarily identify the needs. On the Set for Food website, an example of how findings can be summarized to fit the DSS is provided. The DSS is easy to use and simply requires to answer some questions. However, the challenge is to convert collected data into the format required. In particular, some challenging situations are pretty frequent. For example, some data are impossible to collect, they would require too much time and money, or entail risks for surveyors. Other aspects change continuously or are very difficult to generalize, thus any findings will be quite uncertain. Finally, some evaluations are required, thus some degree of subjectivity is introduced. A good way forward is to include different sources of information in order to triangulate findings and to support them with some evidence. Finally, a sensitivity analysis can evaluate the impact of uncertain data on the final result. The ranking of technologies cannot be immediately applied. Some aspects were only partially considered by the DSS, like availability and affordability, and others were evaluated with a general approach. The technologies guidelines can be very useful to go into more detail. Excluded technologies are very likely inappropriate for the context, while the selected ones have to be confirmed against some very local aspects. The first and most important one is the actual availability, including cost, time needed to procure the required stock, and possibility to deliver it in a certain settlement. Finally, some synergies with other technologies in place or to install could be established, and thus taken into account. One or two technologies will be finally selected. Similar models from different brands could be available, thus a further selection is required. Some stakeholders could provide interesting inputs and try to affect the choice. However, only beneficiaries should always be involved, at least to some extent, because they will have to accept the technology and facilitate its introduction. Different participatory mechanisms are possible, from public discussions to demonstrations of the available products. However, at the end of the day, the implementing agency is the ultimate responsible of technology introduction, thus should take the final decision. However, the selection of technologies will only be the first step of the new humanitarian action.